dear students, so I think all of you are quite good at your home. So today, now in this session, we will do some kind of revision of the chapter agriculture. Is it clear? So you see, before your terminal exam, we have already started this agriculture chapter, and in between we have discontinued the chapter for your exam. So to make it some kind of continuation, I just want to remind you whatever we have studied before your exam, so for your terminal exam. Is it clear? So we have started this chapter agriculture. We have already started. So agriculture means what? All the productive activities. Is it clear? So what do you understand by the term agriculture? Agriculture is the way to do some kind of productive production, or you can say it is the method to do some kind of production. A simple word. All productive activities can be referred as what? Agriculture. Okay. So now see this agriculture, as here they have written primary occupation. Now I think all you have remembered what are occupations, what are economic activities which we have already completed in our previous sessions, and we have discussed about the various types of occupation or the other types of economic activities. Okay. So first of all is what primary occupation. Now what do you understand by the term primary occupation? Primary occupation means what? The occupation that are quite related with some kind of nature or work, or the occupation or the activities where the people quite directly engage themselves into the nature. Yes, or directly depend on the nature. These are known as what? Primary occupation. Okay. So now in here, this primary occupations we can classify as agriculture. One of the important primary occupation we can say agriculture. Yes. And the others, what are the other types of primary occupations? Lumbering, gathering of foods, collection of foods, we can say from forest. These were the primary occupations in the early age. Okay. And now the one mode of primary occupation is for very important mode is for agriculture. And what do you understand by the term agriculture? Agriculture means all productive activities. Okay. For example, here I have written now, in agriculture, all these terms can be comprises of, such as farming. The farming means what? Farming simply we can say that cultivation of paddies, cultivations of wheat, cultivations of other grains, cereals, cash crops, etc., etc. Isn't it? So in a open field where the farmer used to plow the, and when the farmer used to, or the people or the individual or the laborers, they used to do some kind of activities related to some kind of production of grains, they are termed as what? Farming. Is it clear? So next is what? Pisciculture. Pisciculture means what? Rearing of fish. Is it clear? And in essence, what we can say that mean palan or pancha palan rules you are not wow. So this is what? Rearing of fish for commercial purpose, not only for self-consumption, but the commercial purpose as well. Is it clear? So next is what? Animal rearing. Now what do you understand by the term animal rearing? Animal rearing is what? Rearing of cattle. Is it clear? Or we can say animal husbandry also. That means what? Rearing of cattle for various purposes, such as we can say poultry farming, such as rearing of this hens, rearing of ducks, all we can say that for various egg purpose, for various meat purpose, isn't it? Then we can say rearing of goats, rearing of pigs, then cow, horses, buffaloes, all these things. All these can be count in a single word, that is for animal rearing or animal husbandry. Okay. So next is what? Dairy farming. Dairy farming means what? The way or the matter where the special types of cattle they used to rear only for milk purpose. Dairy means what? For milk purpose. So for, and this is also some kind of cheese also, lots of things we can get from milk. Now, only for these purpose, the people used to rear animals, such as we can say buffaloes, we can say cows, we can say goat also, because goat milk, the milk of the goat is also, you know, high nutrition. It contains high nutrition and it is quite good for health also. And for these things, the people used to daily farm. So this is also a farming. Okay, so but it is daily farming means what? Rearing of cattle. And farming in simple term, farming means what? That doing some kind of cultivation. Yes, or growing, you know, paddies, or we can say rice cultivation, wheat cultivation, maize, bajra, any types of, you know, cereals and cash crops also. So next is what? Horticulture. Now what do you mean by horticulture? Horticulture means what? You know, farming or cultivations of vegetables and fruits for commercial purpose. Yes. So basically, the people used to, you know, that you know, they used to cultivate these fruits, these the garden of the fruits. We can say orchards, and we can say, you know, there is vegetables only for. At the same time, here with this horticulture, again one more important term is, you know, related. It is known as what? Truck farming. We can say truck farming also. So this term is also very important. Truck farming. So truck farming is what, you know, whenever the people used to cultivate the vegetables in their, you know, particular land, and where now these vegetables have to be, you know, taken to some kind of nearby market and they have to be sold.
At
India. So these things are quite very important, as these are of you know, it is quite only some kind of the revision class only. And in our next session we will discuss about the types of agriculture. So basically on the mode of the practice of agriculture, the entire types are classified into various forms. Okay, suppose if the question may come, suppose write down what are the types of agriculture, you have to mention on the basis of ownership, on the basis of availability of water, on the basis of you know that mode of you know practice, the entire class agriculture practice, agriculture you know method has been classified into various types, such as we can say intensive agriculture, extensive agricultures, we can say subsistence, or we can say sedentary, we can say you know that shifting cultivation also, which can be said as zoom cultivation. Again we can say suppose you know private sector or the private sector collective or cooperative cultivations, we can say dry farming, we can say irrigated farming, we can say wet farming, all these things.